So today we'll study how to create a binary search tree using C language. Before we go for the coding, just to brief about what is binary search tree. It's a tree in which for any parent, the left child will be smaller. And right child will be greater. And we know that binary trees can be represented using two methods, linked list and arrays. To implement binary search tree, we'll try to implement it using linked list. And let us take an example data. 40, 30, 70, 20. So always the first node will become the root node. Take the next data, it is smaller than 40, it should be attached as a left child. Next comes 70, it is greater than 40, so it is attached as a right child. Next 20, it is less than 40, less than 30, so it will be attached here. If you go for the linked list representation of this, this is how it appears. We have 40. Here we have the address of the left child, 30. Address of the right child, 70. This has the address of its left child. This is a leaf node. Both pointers are null. It doesn't have a right child, so null. And again, 70 is a leaf node, so both the pointers are null. Now we'll try to implement this program using C language using linked list. So each of this node we have to represent it using doubly linked list concept. So we'll represent it as struct node. We require three portions to store the data and one pointer to hold the address of left child, another pointer to hold the address of the right child. So data, we'll assume that we are going to store integer data, so int data. And we have address of left child and right child. So we have struct node L child. So L child is a pointer variable which can hold the address of a struct node. Similarly, we have R child which is a pointer variable to hold the address of a right child. And the entire tree is represented by the root node, which is declared initially as null. So struct node star root, we have declared root as a pointer variable of the type struct node and we initialize that to null. It means initially the tree is empty. So with the assumption of this struct node, we'll now try to create a module which is for creation of a BST. This create module, then we have, in addition to this, we'll try to understand three tree traverses, pre-order, in-order and post-order. So we have total four modules. One is create tree, second in-order traversal, third pre-order traversal and fourth post-order traversal. All these functions will be called from the main program. So we are not going to write the main program, we'll just concentrate only on the modules. So now we'll try to write the create module. So this is a structure node that we have defined and we have declared root, which is a pointer variable and which is initialized to null. And now we'll write the create module. So we'll go for return type of the create module, which is nothing but it is going to return the address of the root, or if you have taken root as a global variable, we need not return any value. So assuming that root is a global variable, will not return any value. So the return type is void. Name of the function is create and this is your function, or if you want you can write it as create BST. For simplicity I have just taken here create. For this, we need to declare some pointer variables. So we declare some pointer variables, struct, node, star, parent. Struct, node, star, ntem. One more, struct, node, star, x. So we are going to use three pointer variables. X is used for traversal to search the parent node to which the new node ntemp has to be attached. So I again repeat, ntemp is a new node which is to be inserted in the tree, PST. X is used to find the parent to which the new node ntemp has to be added. So depending on whether ntemp is smaller than parent, it will be attached as a left child, and if ntemp is greater than parent, the ntemp will be attached as a right child. But before we do that, we need to traverse and search the parent, and that will be done with the help of the variable x. So before we start, we need to first create a we have to request for the space to store the new node. So using malloc function, we'll try to do that. So we'll go for ntemp is equal to struct node star malloc size of struct node. So we have already studied about malloc function in the linked list. Just to have a recap, malloc function is used for dynamic memory allocation, and it will request for the space which is equal to struct node. So size of struct node will decide how much of space is requested by malloc function, and the first byte of the allocated space will be returned back to ntemp, and this is used for type conversion. So we have created a new node, let us say ntemp. And let us say this is the data that we need to insert, 40, 30, 70 and 20. Initially root is null. We have requested for the space and the address of that space is ntemp. We'll scan this data 40 to store here. So we'll go for scanf %d ampersand of ntemp of data. So if we scan 40, that 40 is stored here. And we need to initially make this both the pointers as null. So this is L child and this is R child. So we'll make it as ntemp of L child is equal to null. At the same time, ntemp of R child is equal to null. So we have created a new node. We have scanned the data and we have made both the pointers left child and right child as null. Now we need to traverse. Initially, if you remember, we had created a node called as struct node star root, which was initialized to null, indicating that the tree is an empty tree. The binary search tree is empty. So now we need to check whether we are performing insertion of the new node for the first time, that is in an empty BST. How to check the empty BST? Very simple. You check if it is equal to null. If root is equal to null means the tree is not existing. Whatever is a new node that we have created, that itself should be the root node. So in that case, if root is equal to null, just write here, root itself will be assigned the address of the new node, that is nothing but ntemp. This is what we do, and we can return back. Return. So this was a new node that we requested using ntemp. We made both the pointers as null. We stored the data 40 and initially the root was null. Because the condition is satisfied, the root node is nothing but your ntemp. So this is what we have. Root is now pointing to the node 40. Next time when we again call this module to insert the next data 30, again the same process is repeated. We again request for the space ntemp. I know that 30 is smaller than 40, so I'll place the new node on the left side here. So the address of this node is NTEM, and we scan the data. So the data which is to be stored is 30. We make both the left child and the right child as null. So that is what we have done here, and we are checking if root is equal to null. So definitely root is not equal to null. It is pointing to a node with a data 40. So this condition fails. So now it will come for the else part. So in this case, for the else part, we need to find out the appropriate parent to which the new node 30 has to be attached. So for that, we are going to perform the traversal using the variable x. As I just mentioned, x is used for traversing to find the address of parent to which the new node NTEM has to be attached. So to start traversal, always traversal in a tree will start from the root position. So we start x is equal to root, means we start the traversal from the root position. And how long do we traverse? While x is not equal to null. While x is not equal to null, I'll explain this. We have to first store the whatever is the current value of x in the parent. So we assign x is equal to parent. And now we have to perform the traversal either towards the left subtree or to the right subtree. So how do we do that? So we'll check here based on what is a new node that we need to insert. So the new node will compare that with the x, and initially x is pointing to root. So right now your x is pointing to this node, and when we come inside this while loop, x is not equal to null because x is pointing to this node. The condition x is not equal to null is true, so we come inside. Parent is equal to x means even the parent is also pointing to the same node. So right now all the three are pointing to the same node. Now we'll see towards which direction should we move, whether towards the left or towards the right. So this is how we do. We'll check here if NTEM of data, if it is smaller than x of data. If the new node is smaller than x of data, that means we should traverse towards the left. So in this case, we'll check the new node was 30. Is it smaller than the x of data? Yes. In that case, we need to traverse towards the left. And for traversal, we are using x. So to move towards the left side, we'll write is as x is equal to x of L child. Suppose if the new node NTEM, if NTEM of data, if it is greater than x of data, in that case we need to traverse towards the right direction. So x is equal to x of R child. So we have checked for if it is smaller, we move towards the left child. If the new data to be inserted is greater than x of data, then we are traversing towards the right direction or the right subtree by making x is equal to x of R child. In case it is not less than and greater, means it is equal to, and we'll just assume that we are not going to store the duplicate data. So we'll write here else. So when we'll come to this else part is when both of these condition fails, means NTEM of data is neither smaller nor greater, means it is equal to x of data. We'll not do any kind of insertion. So in that case, we'll just write here a message, printf duplicate data not allowed. Duplicate data not allowed, and we'll just try to return back because there is no meaning in searching because the data is already existing and we need not perform the insertion. Otherwise, we'll just try to end up this while loop. So with respect to this case, we'll try to see what happens. So x was pointing to this node. X is right now not equal to null. We enter the while loop. Parent is also pointing to the data x. If the new node is smaller, yes, this condition is true. That means we are going to traverse in the left direction. So x was pointing here, and x is equal to x of L child means what is x of L child? It is equal to null. That means because of this statement, x is no more pointing to this node, but it will become null. and when it comes back, again when we check the condition, x is not equal to null. This is not true because now x is equal to null. That means we come outside the while loop. So when we come outside the while loop, what we have got is the parent is pointing to this node. X is no more pointing to this node because your x has become null. So parent is pointing to this node. So at the end of this while loop, what we come to know is the parent node to which the new node ntemp has to be attached. So now we'll write the remaining part here. Once we come outside the while loop, we have got the address of the parent. We know ntemp is a new node that is to be attached. The only part left out is whether the new node ntemp has to be attached as a left child or as a right child to the parent node. So in BST we know for a parent the left child must be smaller and the right child must be greater. So we'll check that condition here outside the while loop. If ntemp of data, if it is smaller than parent of data. If it is smaller than parent of data means ntemp should be attached as left child. So we'll write it here. So in that case, parent of L child is equal to ntemp. So we'll come back to the tracing part here. The parent is pointing here. We have come outside the while loop and we have got the address of the parent. And now we are checking ntemp, which is 30. Is it smaller than parent of data? Yes, 30 is smaller than 40. In that case, the ntemp should be attached as a left child. So this was null. Now this will hold the address of this. So this is how the new node ntemp has been attached as a left child of the parent. In case else, it should be either smaller or either greater than the parent, because if it is duplicate, we are going to return back from here itself. So only two cases will happen. Either the new node has to be attached as a left child or as a right child. So else part means the ntemp is greater than the ntemp of data is greater than the parent data. So in this case, the new node should be attached as a right child. So we'll see one more case where the new node can be attached as a right child, and this completes the end of the module, that is create module. So first we inserted the root node. Initially the root was empty, so whatever was a new node, it has become the root node. For the second time, when we requested for the space, we had scanned the data 30, and we started the traversal of the tree by assigning x is equal to root. And for the very first time, after one iteration, your x has become null, so we had come outside because x had become null and parent was pointing here. Because the new node was smaller, it got attached as a left child. Now we'll go for the next data, that is 70. So we have to insert that. Again the same process, we'll request for the new space. Now the new node is always represented by ntemp, so I'll take this as ntemp, and by using malloc function the space is requested. We are scanning the data 70, we are making both the pointers as null. Again we are checking if you are inserting for the first time, no. So in that case we start traversal. X again points to the root node. X is not null. We enter inside the while loop. Parent is pointing to x, means here. And then again we now try to search for the parent to which the new node has to be attached. So new node is 70. So parent is equal to x, it is pointing here. Now we are checking if ntemp of data is greater than, first we are checking for smaller than. If it is smaller than x of data, is it smaller? No, the condition fails. Now we are checking if ntemp of data is greater. Yes, ntemp of data is greater. In that case we are moving towards the right direction. So x is equal to x of L child. So x was pointing here. Now x is pointing to the right child. What is right child? It is null. So now right now x is equal to null. Parent is still pointing to this node. So when we come back, the condition fails. We come outside the while loop. That means we have found the parent to which the new node ntemp has to be attached. So we come to this portion. The new data is 70. We are checking and parent is pointing to 40. So if n temp of data, is it smaller than parent of data? No. So it comes for the else part. In that case, the new data has to be attached as a right child. So 70 is greater than 40. So the right child was null. Now that will be having the address of the new node, that is 70. We'll just try to have one more tracing for this. The next data which is to be attached is 20. So we'll just write it here. So this is your n temp. So this is no more your n temp. Again, we start initializing or traversing from the position root. So x is equal to root. Parent is also assigned to x. As you can see here, this is your new node with the data 20. And this is your n temp. And we make both the pointers as null. We'll start the traversal. X is equal to root while x is not equal to null. Right now x is not null. Parent is equal to x. So parent is pointing here. The new data, is it smaller than x of data? 20 is less than 40. So in that case, we are traversing towards the left direction. That means this is the left child. So right now x is no more pointing here. It is pointing to the left child. So x is pointing here. When we come back, x is not null because it is pointing to one node. So we enter inside. Parent is equal to x. That means the parent was pointing here. Now it will be pointing to the node where x is pointing. Then again, we check whether the new node 20, is it smaller than x? Is it smaller? Yes. In that case, we need to again traverse in which direction? Left direction. So when we traverse in the left direction, what is the left child address here? Null. That means x becomes null, but parent is still pointing here. And as soon as we enter for the next iteration of while loop, the condition fails and we exit from the while loop. So when we come outside the while loop, we have successfully got the address of the parent to which the new node has to be attached. Right now, parent is pointing to the node 30 and the new node which is to be attached is 20. So now we have to attach this, and based on whether the end temp is smaller or greater than parent, we have to attach this as a left child or a right child. So let us see that. If n temp of data, is it smaller than parent of data? 20 is n temp of data. Is it smaller than parent of data? 20 is less than 30. Condition is true. That means the new node should be attached as a left child. So in that case, this will get connected here. And this is how the new node got inserted. So this is how we have successfully created a BST with the following data: 40, 30, 70 and 20. So now we'll try to understand how to write the code for tree traversal in order, pre-order and post-order. Recording all the videos.